The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and gracious God, it is a privilege to worship you this day in this community of saints. May our praise be joyful, may our hearts be turned toward you, and may our souls be quenched with the waters of your word. We give you all glory and praise and gratitude this day and forever. Amen.
Please stand in body or spirit and join me for the call to worship. As we gather today, we call on you,
our Father who art in heaven.
As we gather today, we lift up who you are and what you mean to us.
Hallowed be your name.
As we gather today, we seek your ways, not our own.
Your kingdom come, your will be done.
As we gather today, we say sorry to you and one another.
Forgive us as we forgive.
As we gather today, we need you.
Give us this day our daily bread. Lead us away from temptation.
Deliver us from evil. As we gather today, we pray.
Amen.
Let us sing to the glory of God from your bulletin insert, Hymn Morning Has Broken. Small kiddie pool with me. Anyone out? Do you like to pray by yourself or your family?
I'd like to on the session down there, I'm not sure.
Your family? Does anybody have a prayer with you now? I think it's always not getting water. Okay, let's go to the answer. Dear Lord, thank you for this wonderful day. With our church family, good churches. We love each one of your friends. Please let us address the sermon. They're wonderful, and then let us be able to all have fun with each other. Inscribed on a cellar wall in Cologne, Germany during World War II. And this song is called Description of Hope. I believe in the sun, even when it is not shining, and I believe in love, even when there's no one. I believe in God, even when He is silent. I believe through any trial, there is always a way. But sometimes in the suffering and hopeless despair, my heart cries for shelter. To know someone's there, but a voice rises within me, saying, hold on, my child, I'll give you strength, I'll give you hope, just stay a little while. I believe in the sun, even when it is not shining. I believe in love, even when there's no one there. But I believe in God, even when He is silent. I believe through any trial, there is always a way. May there someday sunshine, may there someday be happiness, may there someday be love, may there someday be turn our hearts and minds to God and ask for the illumination of the Holy Spirit. God of abundant life, your grace is our daily bread. Nourish us by your word and fill us with your spirit so that we may grow in faith and love through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our first scripture reading today comes from James chapter 2, verse 14 through 17. What good is it, my brothers and sisters, if you say you have faith but do not have works? Can faith save you? If a brother or sister is naked and lacks daily food, and one of you says to them, go in peace, keep warm, and eat your fill, yet you do not supply their bodily needs, what is the good of that? So faith by itself, if it has no works, is dead. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Our second scripture reading today comes from Matthew chapter 6, verse 15, or 5 through 15. And whenever you pray, do not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father, who is in secret, and your Father, who sees in secret, will reward you. When you are praying, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles do, for they think that they will be heard because of their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask Him. Pray then in this way. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. And do not bring us to the time of trial, but rescue us from the evil one. For if you forgive others their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive others, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
What is prayer? Why do we pray? When we pray, for whom do we pray? These are questions that we ask each other in creating today's lesson. We discuss that makes us decide to pray and what we expected from prayer. We discuss that we recite the Lord's Prayer every Sunday, but that we are not sure why.
As teenagers and young adults, we discuss events that happen in our daily lives and how we are affected by them. We discuss that many of us are athletes and participate in extracurricular activities. We discuss that many times our prayers are for ourselves and may not take others in consideration.
We also discuss that many times we pray for others. However, after we pray for them, we move on to our next event or activity. We decide that our focus was going to be on what God's expectations are for us after we pray.
First, when we begin reciting the Lord's Prayer, it is important to know that we are praying to the one we have accepted as our Savior who is over us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Jesus begins his exemplary prayer by acknowledging to whom he is praying. God is our Father, meaning that he cares for us. God resides in heaven, implying that he is above us. We hallow his name, meaning we declare that it is holy. This opening line, then, recognizes that God is both our Father and our King. He loves us, and he is far greater than we.
Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. After acknowledging the character of God, we pray for his purpose, because God cares for us and is greater than we. We submit our will to his. We trust that his way is better and pray that his will be accomplished on earth.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we also have forgiven our debtors. We not only desire God's will on a grand scale, but also on the smaller scale of our lives. We look to Him for our daily needs, spiritual, practical, relational, emotional, and physical.
Our biggest need is to be forgiven. Without God's forgiveness, we are dead in sin. With His forgiveness, we are made alive in Christ. Because we are forgiven, we are called to forgive. Forgiveness restores our fellowship with God and with others. With forgiveness, we can obey the command to love God and love others.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. This final request demonstrates a heart that is eager to please God. God will not lead us into temptation. He is not the author of evil. This prayer is an agreement with God that we do not want to sin against Him. We pray to be aware of the evil that tempts us and to readily see the escape He has provided. Some say that temptation in this verse may also refer to trials. In this sense, we are asking God to keep us from harm.
So why do we pray, and why do we say the Lord's Prayer? First, we pray hope for a better world, not only for ourselves, but more importantly for those around us. We should realize that in prayer, we are not just saying the words to pacify time. We are praying for salvation, we are praying for friends and family in need, we are praying for peace, and we are praying that through God we can be better people to carry out His plan. We are praying that we can treat others better. We are praying that we can sympathize and empathize with those who are in pain. We are praying for those who are treated unfairly, and we are praying because we realize through the help of our Lord, we can be better people. We say the Lord's Prayer because we have learned that the dissecting the Lord's Prayer, we are acknowledging that God is our Savior and that we are to live our lives on earth as He would want us to do in heaven. We say the Lord's Prayer because we know that is the Lord who gives us our daily bread so that we can continue living and spreading His word. We recite the Lord's Prayer because we know that throughout our lives, although we may be tempted to go in wrong directions, it will be our God who forgives us and leads us in the right direction. We say the Lord's Prayer because we know if we can follow this simple prayer, we will be better people and we will be accepted into God's kingdom for eternity. May all God's people say, Amen.
Thank you.
stand in body or spirit and confess the faith of our baptism using the word of Apostles' Creed in your bulletin. Christians, what do you believe?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Ghost, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Please be seated.
But I'm going to use it anyway. Welcome. Welcome all of you here to our annual worship service together at the pool. A time of great fellowship and enjoyment of the out-of-doors, and especially this time, our talented and capable youth and young adults here of I am so happy that they have put so much work into this, and I'd also like to recognize Laura Holland and Vicki Wilt and Dawn Boggs and Brenna, who mothered this whole process. To help put this worship service together, and especially our talented people. And speaking of talented people, we have two people from the Piedmont congregation. What's that? Speak up. Really?
Train.
Huh? Train. Oh. Okay, well, I can't compete with trains, I'm sorry. We have two talented people from the Piedmont congregation who are in a theatrical production, Cinderella, at the Allegheny College, the Apple Alley Players, Lori Groves and Evie Groves. Evie, you just heard her sing. She has sang and danced her way into our hearts. Lori plays the fairy godmother and was transformative. The prince was charming, and Cinderella just cleaned up and ran away with the show. This afternoon is their final performance. Huh?
It's at 7.
It's at 7. Okay, change of time. 7 o'clock this afternoon, or this evening. Allison and I went last night. We might go again. I mean, it was that great. So I encourage you all, $15 at the door.
For adults, 10 for kids.
For 10 for kids, yep. So let's see, announcements that need to be made. This church secretary, Heather Rochella at Keyser, will be taking next Thursday and Friday off to do family things and vacation. And so any announcements, anything for the bulletin for next Sunday at Keyser needs to be to her by Tuesday so she could get that in. Are there any other announcements from either church? Yes.
Just wanted to make sure that we knew for the offering today, the kids together had decided they had asked to do a joint offering for that money to go to
Thank you so much for reminding me. I would have completely forgot it. Normally in these joint worship services, we don't take up an offering because we couldn't figure out how to divide it between the two churches. Well, the solution is that we don't do that. We are taking up an offering, and the children, the youth, the young adults have decided to support the Mineral County Humane Society with this money. So very worthy cause, very much needed. So we will shortly be doing that. Anything else? Okay, now is the time for us to share our joys and concerns that we'd like to lift up in prayer. So are there any joys and concerns you'd like to share at this time? Yes.
My brother-in-law passed away a few days ago. Pete
Smidlin.
Yes.
Is that your brother or?
Brother-in-law.
Okay, but it's not your brother. Okay, the other side of the family. Pete Smidlin.
S-C-H-M-I-D-L-E-N.
I'll forget how to pronounce that before long. So. All right, friends and family of Pete Smidlin who passed away last week?
Two days ago.
Okay. Also prayers for
Carrie,
the Staggers. I'm trying to get that name out. The Carrie Staggers' mother, Marion Miller, passed away week before last, or last weekend. The funeral was yesterday. So prayers for her whole family, which is huge. It's the Ravencroft family. She was one of 12 siblings. Yes?
The boys would like extra prayers for their meeting and pop-up if they had to put their little doll Harley down.
Okay, prayers for Mimi and Pop-Pop. Okay. Mimi, Pop-Pop, and that's whose father?
It's my parents.
Your parents, okay. They lost their... the family pet, the dog. That's a very hard thing. We have been through that many, many times. We also need to lift up in prayer Jack Landis and Jackie Lucas, who are in nursing homes. I don't believe we have anybody else in a nursing home, do we? Okay. Ron Foster had a knee replacement recently. Is there any? Yes.
Kermit Baker still has part of a finger.
Kermit.
He didn't lose the whole thing.
Kermit had his finger where it shouldn't have been. So we'll. And he got out of physical labor at the church yesterday. So the lengths that he will go to avoid that is just amazing. Yes?
Mike Mander at the American Legion Post in Keyser, Dave Frederick, he's down at Western Maryland right now. He's having the second time this week he's been in the hospital for chest pain.
Okay, Dave Frederick from the American Legion in Keyser at Western Maryland?
He's at Western Maryland.
With chest pains. Okay, so prayers for Dave. Anyone else?
Max from our church fast for the path of surgery.
Okay, Barbara Murphy Babs is having cataract surgery.
Had.
Okay, and it all went well, and she can see all the. Her sister told me years ago that she had when she had cataract surgery, she could see how dirty her wallpaper was, and she wished she hadn't had it. So, yes.
Ben Starr, the teenager in Cumberland, who's been going to Johns Hopkins for treatments, he was released yesterday, but then had to go back with pain. He has kidney stones on top of it, so keep him in prayers.
Okay, Ben.
Starr.
Ben Starr.
The student Fort Hill.
He's had treatments that is for cancer,
yes.
And now he's got kidney stones on top of that. All right, so prayers for Ben. Prayers for the family of Fred Taylor. Dorothy Lynn Taylor is our bell choir director, and Fred, her husband, passed away a week before last. Are there any other prayer requests? So at this time, let us all stand and share signs of peace and reconciliation with one another, and may the peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you all.
Actually, mine wasn't.
be with you.
And all sin
will
be with you.
The Lord be with you. The feast has been prepared. This is not the table of the Keyser or Piedmont Presbyterian churches. This is not the table of the PC USA.
This is the table of our Lord Jesus Christ, and Christ invites all those to trust in him, to share in the feast, experience his presence, and be strengthened to share in his ongoing life and the mission of God. Let us pray. Holy God, you are worthy of praise. The heavens are joyful and earth is glad. And, O Lord, we are grateful. Sustaining God, you created all that is seen and unseen, and you care for all of your creation by your promises to your people. Through your word and the great cloud of witnesses, we know you are faithful to your promises, even when we fail to live as authentic as human beings. So, Lord, we are grateful. Redeeming God, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to bear your fullness in the world. Born of Mary, he shares our life. Eating with sinners, he welcomes us. Guiding his children, he leads us. Visiting the sick, he heals us. Dying on the cross, he saves us. Risen from the dead, he gives us new life. Living with you, he prays for us. And so, O Lord,
we are grateful.
In gratitude, we take this bread and this cup and proclaim the death and resurrection of our Lord. Receive our sacrifice of praise. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon us, that this meal may be a communion in the body and the blood of our Lord. Make us one with Christ and with who all who share this feast. Unite us in faith, encourage us with hope, inspire us to love, that we may serve as your faithful disciples, that we may honestly say, O Lord,
we are grateful.
Lord, we lift up all those who are weary with heavy burdens. We pray especially for Jack, Jackie, Ron, Kermit, Dave, Ben, Babs, and Caden. And Lord, we ask that all who are sick in body, mind, or spirit come to know your healing grace and love, and may those who damage themselves through addictions be awakened to new life. God of mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we lift up those who grieve the loss of friends and loved ones, and we pray especially for the friends and family of Pete Schmidlin, Marion Miller, Fred Taylor, and Mimi and Pop Pop, who have lost their blessed family dog. And Lord, we ask that they may all come to know the comfort of your presence in their sorrow. God of mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, we celebrate your good gifts. We rejoice in all of your abundant blessings. We celebrate this opportunity to be in your nature, to enjoy the fellowship around the table and the fellowship of the swimming pool. And Lord, we praise you, Eternal God, through Christ, your word made flesh in the holy and life-giving Spirit now and forever. And may all God's people say, Amen. had not thought that, of that before, that we should be praying with seasoning, but we absolutely should. Our Lord Jesus, on the night of his arrest, of his betrayal and his arrest, in the midst of the one who would betray him, took a loaf of bread, and after having blessed it, he gave thanks, and he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, and he said, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup. He said, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for the forgiveness of sins. Every time you drink of it, do this in remembrance of me." For every time you drink this cup, eat this bread, you do proclaim the saving death of our risen Lord until he comes. I ask you to come forward in two lines. Please mind your fingers in the juice.
Let us pray. God of grace, you renew us at your table with the bread of life. May this food strengthen us in love and help us to serve you in each other. We ask this in the name of Jesus the Lord. Amen. Let us stand in body or spirit and sing to the glory of God.
Let's sing this through twice. Got short.
Upon you and give you peace. And all God's people said,
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Did a nice job with the service.